Okay, this is Melt Festival 2013. With me is Lizzie and Max from Miss Mister. Hi, guys.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Hi, Hello. Dan. How you doing?
Doing well.
I'm great. Here. Great weather, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very lovely.
We were saying that the set here, though, is a bit sort of, you know, post-apocalyptic, and it seems there's a little discord with the beautiful weather and then this apocalyptic set.
I'm really particularly loving the disco balls on the ends of all the cranes. It's a really nice touch. It feels very Miss Mister.
It does,
yeah. It? It feels primed for a Miss Mister set, I feel like, yeah. Didn't know what this would be, but I knew I didn't see what you thought you saw in me. I dropped the gun, so sure you'd split and run, ready for the worst before the damage was done. Germany has been sort of like our greatest supporter in the world sort of to date, and so for us it's such an awesome opportunity to be able to travel here and be gigging around Europe all summer and to be able to like play festivals like Melt, and this is our first big German summer festival, so we're quite excited about it.
The hardest thing about being on tour is not being in New York, because that's home, and there's so much about our music is about New York, so it's weird to not be playing it in New York.
What are you doing at home when you're not writing music or playing?
Well, we're going to shows and catching up with friends, and Max is producing with some other artists, and I have a record label that I run at home, and a bit of vintage shopping, and then a little bit of rest. But usually we're home for like 4 days maximum. It's becoming more like home to be on the road than to be at back in New York, which is sort of this weird new balance we're finding in our lives. Welcome to the inner workings of my mind, so dark and foul I can't disguise, can't disguise. And I think we all sort of influence and inspire one another, because I think we sort of came to New York at this sort of classic time when you graduate from school and you all just sort of want to pursue your dream and see how far you can take it. And so it's fun to be sort of a working hard artist in New York City. And it was fun for us because we have a new single called Think of You, and we just released a new video for it. And we invited a ton of them to come and be in the video, whoever could sort of come and make it that day. And so it sort of, for the first time, captures a little bit of like our life. Like some sick love potion,
I was addicted to your touch. You met in university, is that right? What was it like, love at first sight, or?
I mean, like, creative love.
Sort of.
I mean,
the thing is, we'd like known each other. We knew who each other were while at school, but it wasn't until afterwards that we really sort of connected. But really, almost immediately after we started writing music together, there was a sort of immediate connection. I think we were both sort of at that same place of, you know, interested and creatively driven, but really green and didn't really know what we were doing, and sort of recognize the kindred spirit in the other person.
I think that's what's sort of the most fantastic and magical piece about this project, is that neither of us has really been in a band before this, and yet we were immediately sort of on the same musical page. And often when we were writing songs, even, you know, for something like Bones, which is the first original track we ever wrote together, if we do sort of get combative about a sound or about a lyric or a movement or how we're going to structure something, it's only because we want the song to be the best version of itself, and we both completely recognize that in one another, and it definitely makes us a stronger, I don't know, musical band. You may pain your lover, infidelity not discreet. I really like how you say experiment. You say experiment.
Experiment.
Which is sort of how my dad says it. So, okay. Side note.
Okay, cool. So take it as a compliment.
We digress. We'll go on.
Talking about colors, you have like a little hair dyeing fetish and hair curling fetish.
It's true.
I thought so. What is it about?
I like changing it regularly. I sort of always have like a gut feeling of what sort of a color theme I'm sort of heading towards. But I don't really decide until I'm like in the chair. And the woman who does it for me is so amazing, like sort of like a genius and an artist. And
Lizzie,
she really does, but she really, she's amazing. And she really encourages me as to be like as mental about it as I want to be. So this was sort of like psychedelic candy.
Okay, guys, we don't have any time more, I see. Thank you for the interview. Have fun. And let's get together,
nice
talk
to
about
you.
Colors
let's
and stuff like
let's
that.
Have a beer later.
Let's have a beer later. Okay, thanks.